For your eternal robes you shed because amongst all the tenements and allow him to pay for it over 10 years. Because it's built now into your housing. Because those roads that are directly related to your tenement clearly help to define the quality of the real estate or lack of it. And that is what will determine whether your house will get a higher value as it matures or whether it needs to deteriorate as an asset. And of course, before I go on to the last issue of rent, is to again reinforce this part of the education that I dealt with, that when people acquire homes, there are also incidents of home ownership. Taxes that you become liable to pay as a homeowner. Duties that you become subject to as a homeowner. One tax you must pay is property tax. Once you own a home, people still resist the idea, and that is why our property taxes are less than 1%, perhaps the lowest in the world. Some jurisdictions are as high as 10%. And we want to be like those jurisdictions. We crave the quality of life that we have, but we don't want to pay the price that we pay. Because in the same way that property tax becomes a liability, a duty for property owner, so does vehicle tax, road tax, become a liability or a responsibility for the vehicle owner. In the same way that the status of a married man changes, because he has chosen to take a wife, he must begin to support two people instead of himself. So when his bachelor friends bring the latest smoking jacket, he's not going to put it, it's not bad, but you know, things have changed because his status has changed. And we must be honest with ourselves. So if it's acceptable that when your status in marriage changes and you become Mr. and Mrs. this, and we can deal with that. When it's acceptable that when you have a car, something also has changed, and we can deal with that. Why can't we deal with this? Because as a property owner, whether you want to cash out now or you want to cash out in the future, you have moved in the social status of that society. You are no longer a poor man, because you can leverage that asset for value and for cash. So why then do you want to take the benefit and avoid the burden? And you see government then as being unkind when it says pay your tax. So those are for me real education issues that we must deal with. But I think that there's a generation out there that is catching on to it, because the people we're seeing in the Lagos home stream are people within the age of 30, 35. They're the largest store of people who are emerging as successful leaders. So with home ownership code certifications, painting, maintenance of common parts, and all of that. Because if you don't maintain the common parts, the house is going to deteriorate. And in doing that, painting, again, you energize the economy. Many properties that you see in our society last got a coat of paint either on the day that it was dedicated, or on the day that somebody died, so there's a burial,
on the day that the child is getting married, so visitors are coming to the house.
And then we complain that there is unemployment. There will be unemployment because the service sector of our economy, the paint industry, is not getting real supplies. Artisans. So if we paint our houses at least once every 2 years, we will see the effect in employment. These are some of the resolutions I would like to see emerge from this conference. An agreement about the minimum things that we must do. If we agree in Lagos that every house must be painted once every 2 years, something will move in a positive direction in this economy in terms of employment. And so, housing, therefore, can be a tour de force for really reflecting the economy. And that is the reason why one of the acronyms, just like you have your fire, I have my path for power, agriculture, transportation, and housing. And those are the areas in which we have invested more, relatively more time and energy in the last 2 years, in order to broaden the base of opportunities in the Lagos economy. As far as red tape is concerned, I think that it's a very nice word for democracy, and I agree that it can become a problem, but I don't think that democracy itself is a problem, to the extent that the follow is ordinary meaning body of rules and processes for getting things done. It allows for predictability. When I can anticipate what you will do, and you can anticipate what I will do, then you should be comfortable to work together. But I concede that at the level of government, where we serve a larger number of people, then the potential for those processes to become self-limiting is there. But what governments will do, and what I encourage that government to do, is to automate, so that you can respond to more people in quicker time. So, in terms of land processing, for example, I'm happy to say that our automation experiments are beginning to bear fruit. I can now sign certificates of occupancy electronically, and I can do so outside Nigeria. What I used to do before was carry suitcases on yellow paper, and we were all stopped at an airport. What is all this? It's quite embarrassing. But I don't do that anymore. All I need now is just my laptop, and I can sign online from any part of the world. And with that information, I can tell you, there was a period, I think in August, in 3 days, I signed by 100 COs. And they're being issued and processed now. I have about 147 in my box, and over the holiday, I should get rid of them. So, but that's where we are today. That's what automation has done for us. Again, we've used technology on the Lagos Homes Initiative even before we started delivering the houses. We were accused of having sold it to ourselves. So we needed to be as open as Caesar's wife, if you know that story. And so what we decided to do was, we're not going to get involved with anybody in terms of application forms and all of that. The only time you should make contact with us is at the mortgage counseling stage, where we will have qualified online. So that's what we've done. So everything about the Lagos Homes is on the Lagos Homes website. So you don't need to come to government, you don't need to see us. So if you put your tax references there, it will prompt you on. If you put your residency number there, it will prompt you on. If you don't put it, it will tell you immediately that you are not qualified for this process, so you can't continue. And so on and so forth. And then you will find as current photographs of houses under construction,
as you want, so you can go from scheme to scheme. You can see the floor plan of every of our houses, you can see the floor status, it's all online. So you can transact business with us on that website. And the final draws there, one of the things that has been on the forefront and on the statements of testimony of every successful beneficiary of the loss of that. They couldn't believe that they did have to go into it and they were successful. So it's brought on a lot of transparency to the process. And so that said, I thank you for inviting me. I hope that I have provoked you sufficiently as you go into your breakout sessions. And without further ado, I now declare this year's conference open. Thank you very much.